Hello everyone, welcome back to the Aspen Tech channel. For those who haven't subscribed yet, please do subscribe the channel and click the bell icon so that you never miss any update from this channel. In our lecture number 13, we will be extracting pure component property data using Aspen Heist, and this data will be helpful while performing extractive distillation column simulation. First, we will see an extractive distillation column, how it operates. The components which cannot be separated using the simple distillation needs to be separated using extractive distillation column. The feed which consists of A and B is fed to the column. The solvent C is also fed to the column. C combines with one of them depending on the densities. And in this case, as you can see, C combines with B. The product A is obtained from the top of the first column. This first column is called as extractive column. The mixture B and C is obtained from the bottom of the column. This mixture is sent to the second column, which is the solvent recovery column, where the product B is obtained from the top of the column and C is obtained from the bottom of the column. This obtained C is recycled back to the first column. In another configuration, A combines with C. B is obtained from the bottom of the column, which is the extractive column. This A and C goes to second column, which is the solvent recovery column. A is obtained from the top, C is obtained from the bottom, and C is recycled back. So this is the basic scheme of extractive distillation column. We will go into the detail of this column when we will simulate extractive distillation column in Aspen Heist and Plus. So our today's exercise is related to the selection of a suitable solvent for the extractive distillation process. While selecting solvent, we must ensure that the two liquid phases formed during the extraction process have enough difference in densities. Obviously, the separation will take place and density difference should be there. Otherwise, these two phases cannot be separated. And for the selected solvent, we also need to check its density against the existing liquid phase to check which liquid phase is heavier. The liquid phase which will be heavier will be obtained from the bottom of the column. So in our problem statement number one, we have to separate acetone and water, and the solvent to be used is 3-methylhexane. So I will quickly go to Aspen Heist. I will add the component acetone, water, 3-methylhexane. There is no need to go to simulation environment. This interface is enough to give us information. I will just double click on it, go to critical, and you see in base properties, the ideal liquid density of acetone is 790 kg per cubic meter. Similarly for water, it's 998 kg per cubic meter. For 3-methylhexane, it's 690.2. It's quite obvious that acetone and the solvent will form a liquid phase and water will be separated in the first column. Likewise, in the diagram which I have shown to you, that A stands for acetone, B stands for water, C stands for 3-methylhexane. A plus C means acetone and 3-methylhexane will form a liquid phase while water will be separated from the. Now we have to decide whether it will be obtained from the top of the column or bottom of the column. If you see the densities, its density is 790 while its density is 690.2 and the water density is 998. It means that the water is denser than these two. It means water will be obtained from the bottom of the column while A plus C means acetone and 3-methylhexane will be obtained from the top of the column, which will be taken to the second column where the separation will take place and this solvent will be recovered. Similarly, in our problem statement number 2, we have to separate toluene and n-heptane and we have to select the solvent phenol. Similarly, I have added the three components toluene, n-heptane and phenol. We have to separate toluene and n-heptane using extractive distillation, for which we have to select solvent phenol. Now clicking on it, as you can see, the properties of these three components are placed. The ideal liquid density of toluene is 870 kg per cubic meter, for n-heptane is 686.8 kg per cubic meter, and for phenol is 1056 kg per cubic meter. It means that n-heptane will be separated in this column while toluene and phenol will make a mixture over here. It means that diagram number 2 will be followed, in which A plus B means toluene plus n-heptane will be fed to the column, phenol will be fed to the column, n-heptane will be obtained from the top of the column while toluene and phenol will make a mixture and they will be separated in the second column because the density of n-heptane is lower than these two. So that's all from my side for today's simulation. Please do subscribe the channel, watch the video, like the video, share with others. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned.